The Inspector General's report on the Clinton email probe unearthing a pattern of anti-Trump bias by high-ranking officials at the FBI. But now a new Wall Street Journal op-ed suggests Special Counsel Robert Mueller's investigation faces a serious legal obstacle as a result, stating, although Mr. Horowitz could not definitively ascertain whether this bias directly affected specific FBI actions in the Clinton email investigation, it nonetheless affects the legality of the Trump-Russia collusion inquiry. So has the IG report poisoned Mueller's investigation? Let's talk to constitutional law professor for the George Washington School of Law and somebody who knows about poison trees, Mr. Jonathan Turley. Good morning to you, Jonathan.
Hi, Steve.
Well, what do you think?
I wouldn't bet on this horse, honestly. I have brought malicious and selective prosecution challenges in criminal cases, and they're very hard to make out. The 1970s were sort of the high point of these types of claims. Also, it's important to remember that this report dealt with the Clinton email scandal, not as much the Russian collusion scandal, so it's somewhat removed. Now, having said that, while I don't think this necessarily means that charges will likely be tossed, it may, in fact, undermine the case in other respects. The court may give more serious consideration to selective prosecution claims. It may allow greater discovery. And these investigators often have to be called to the stand.
Right.
If they've been implicated on bias issues, that could conceivably make it into a hearing or even a trial.
And one of the things we learned from the Inspector General's appearance up on Capitol Hill last week is that was there anti-Trump bias at the FBI? Oh, yeah. And then, Jonathan, we've got the story that is circulating this morning, and that is that one of the senators from the Commonwealth of Virginia, Mark Warner, apparently said to somebody, was overheard saying, yeah, go get me another glass of wine and I'll tell you all the stuff that Robert Mueller's got. What?
Yeah, this is my new chapter to my expanding book of jokes you do not make in Washington.
Right.
You know, look, I don't know what's worse. He had secrets and he was willing to share them, or he had secrets and he was just joking.
Right.
Either way, it's serious. The Democrats cannot say with people like Chairman Nunes that he's lacking professionalism or independence and go around joking about, you know, I'll trade, you know, secrets for booze.
Sure.
Now, I have respect for Senator Warner. I'm sure he didn't mean that. It was a joke. But at this time, with everything at stake, you might want to keep those jokes to yourself.
Yeah. No kidding. All right. Jonathan Turley joining us today from our nation's capital.
Thanks, Steve.
Thank you very much for joining us live.